are at the Strand today. We've parked the blue boat here. Numbers are growing, but we need more of you calling out rebels. This is calling out all rebels. Come to the Strand. Support us. Come to the Strand. We're growing in numbers, but we need more of you here. Calling out all rebels. Come to the Strand.
Good thing to know, isn't it?
Act now. Act right now.
From the other bit of the road and have joined us just now. You're all brilliant and wonderful. I'm so happy you're here. It's a real honour to be here with all of you. You're totally awesome. And we're going to make this day the best. Something that will bite and stop the kind of destructive practices from happening that we're witnessing are on now such a big scale. I just wanted to say, you know, why has essentially Western law not protected the earth in time and with the degree of severity and penalty that we needed? Looking back at 400 years ago, essentially a bunch of philosophers based in the UK, John Locke, for example, said that you could privatize nature. Nature could become a private right. You could hold it, you could sell it, you could buy it. And that concept is very much enshrined in the way in which we conceive of nature here. It does seem a bit odd, especially when you contrast it with the hundreds and thousands of years of wisdom of indigenous people who have never conceived of nature as something that is privately held, to be bought and sold, to be extracted, exploited. So unless and until, for example, we get rid of this concept that nature is something that we own, we have mastery over, we have sovereign rights over, we own the freehold, we can destroy, trade, and do what we like, I think we will carry on exactly as we are. So one of the most important parts, I think, of the legal revolution that we need to have is to re-see the world with new eyes and to see that our private holding of nature is antithetical to life on Earth. You know, if we ourselves and corporations in, you know, can own, buy, sell, destroy at their own leisure, then we have really lost sight of the connectedness of life and the sacredness of life. The second legal bit of revolution that we need is, in fact, to get rid of the concept of limited liability. Limited liability means exactly what it says. It means it takes away the moral, legal, financial accountability for the destruction of nature. If you are a company, you are literally, as a limited liability company, acting with impunity for all the destructive damage that's going on. And that's a huge piece of legal innovation that happened in the 18th and 19th century. That's what gave rise to the kind of toxic capitalism that is destroying nature. So we need to see that our own legal structures that are given effect to every day in the courts behind me, those are responsible also for the way in which we see our world and the way in which we are having now to rise up and defend and break the laws. So I would like to, first of all, congratulate all of the people who are here who've taken time off to support this uprising, to tell you to carry on doing that, whether you're willing to be arrested or not, to give an honouring to the people who were arrested all over the world, 1,000, nearly 200 people who are arrested and, you know, and will be facing trial. You can join them in whatever way that you want, either if you're willing to be arrested or if you're willing to be a supporter or if you're willing to be a conscientious objector in your playground, your school, your everyday life. So thank you very much for coming here. Thank you for listening and carry on all your amazing work.
Thanks, everyone.